Hello everyone, welcome to Semiconductor. Today, let's talk about HBM. In previous episode, we talked about 2.5D, and there was HBM in that 2.5D. HBM stands for High Bandwidth Memory. It is a kind of DRAM and looks like this. For more detailed structure, it has multiple vertically stacked DRAM dies with TSV on top, and also has logic die at the bottom, which also has TSV. Even though it is a kind of DRAM, its circuit is a little bit different with a conventional DRAM die. HBM module has logic die at the bottom, but conventional DRAM die does not have this logic die. Usually, HBM is used for GPU nowadays, but GDDR has been used for GPU so far, before HBM. If so, why people started to use HBM rather than GDDR? Here is comparison between GDDR and HBM. GDDR is placed around GPU on PCB as a separate package, but HBM is placed on silicon interposer within same package of GPU. It means HBM module and GPU are integrated in the same package. For this case, GDDR is 110 by 90 mm, but HBM is 55 by 55 mm, much smaller. Also, HBM is located more close to GPU, which is good for fast data processing. So, here is a list of advantages of HBM over GDDR. HBM has smaller form factor with higher memory density, memory bandwidth, and capacity. HBM also consumes less power and shows better performance with lower latency. How about disadvantage? It is expensive. It uses TSV and silicon interposer, which increase product cost. So, still GDDR is used for GPU. Let's check structure of HBM with actual product. It is an image of a scanning electron microscope for HBM. If you zoom in a little bit, you can see this. There are DRAM dies and underfill material between dies. If you zoom in a little more, you can see TSV within silicon interposer, and microbump between base logic die and silicon interposer. Packaging process is done by OSAT company like ASE, MCO, and JSAT. But HBM is assembled by memory suppliers like Samsung and SK Hynix. There are two different assembly processes, TC-CUP and TCNCF. TC-CUP means thermal compression with capillary underfill, and uses thermal compression bonding and underfill. TCNCF means thermal compression with non-conductive film, and uses thermal compression bonding and non-conductive film. Major players of HBM are Samsung and SK Hynix. In 2019, Samsung announced HBM 2E memory. It has 8 stack DRAM dies with more than 56,000 TSVs, and they started mass production from February 2020. Samsung also developed industry-first 12 stack DRAM dies for 24 GB in 2019. In July 2020, SK Hynix started mass production of HBM 2E as well. This is a brief introduction to HBM technology. I hope this can help you to understand basic HBM technology. Have a nice day and see you again soon. Bye bye.